students, let's start new chapter today, lines and angles. Now see here, PQ. PQ, it has two end points. See, PQ, it has end points. So what to say for this? We have to say for this line segment. What it is? Line segment. It has definite length. Line segment has definite length. Okay. Now if you observe AB, AB is line. See, PQ is line segment. Why it is line segment? Because it has two end points. We cannot extend this. It has end points. So this PQ is line segment. But if you observe AB, AB, what we have to say for AB? AB is line. This is line. Okay, because see, it has arrow both the sides, means we can extend the line both the sides. This already you have learned previously. What is line? What is line segment? Ray. Okay. So now next, OP. Ray OP. This is ray OP. Is what we can do? We cannot extend the line towards this side. We can extend the line towards this side. Okay. So see, line segment, line and ray. Okay. So AB, AB is the line. Okay. OP, PQ is the line segment and OP is the ray. Now if you observe here, it is given triangle. Here it is given triangle. Now line segment AB and BC intersect at point B. Where the, these two line segments intersect at point B. So in which angle is formed? Angle B. Okay. Then BC, line segment BC and AC intersect at point C. So which angle it is formed here? Angle C. Means we can say BCA. Angle BCA we can say. After that, CA and BA intersect at point A. So here it has formed the angle A. Means here it has formed three angles. See, angle A, B, C, angle B, C, A, angle C, A, B, or we can say angle B, A, C. So three angles it has formed here. Three angles are there in triangles. How many angles are there? Three angles. So how these three angles we got? Well, two line segments C and line segment A, B and line segment B, C intersect at point B. So here angle B for line segment B, C and A, C intersect at point C. So here angle C it is formed. Then B, A and C A intersect at point A. So here angle A is formed. After that if you will see these two lines intersect at point O. These are the two lines PQ and RS. These two lines intersect at point O. So here four angles are formed. Which are the four angles? POS, angle POS, angle SOQ, angle QOR and angle ROP or POR. So here four angles are formed. So lines and angles. Understood? Lines and angles. Okay? Complementary angles. What is meant by complementary angle? When the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degrees, the angles are called complementary angles. What it is given? Sum of the measure of two angles. If it is 90 degrees, then that angles are called complementary angle. Now just see this example. See now, it is. We'll see. We'll find the sum of these both angles. See, 30 degree plus 60 degree. 30 degree plus 60 degree. Sum of these both angles, what we got? 90 degree we got. So these angles, what we can say, these are the complementary angle. Why these are complementary angle? Because the sum of the measure of these two angles, it is 90 degree. So these angles are called complementary angle. Now let's find these angles are complementary or not. So what we have to do? We have to find the sum of these angles. These both angles. If we will get 90 degree, then that angles we can say the complementary angle. So find the sum of these angles. 35 degree plus 65 degree. Okay, 5 plus 5, 10. 6 plus 3, 9 and 1. angles. So these are the complementary angles. These are not complementary angles. Okay. Let's see now supplementary angles. What is meant by supplementary angle? In the sum of the measure of angles is 180 degree. That angles are called supplementary angle. When the sum of the angles it will get 180 degree, then that angles are called supplementary angles. Now see, we find the sum of these both angles 60 degree plus 120 degree. Okay, so 0 plus 0, 0, 6 plus 2, 8, 1, 180 degree. So what we got, sum of these two angles, what we got, 180 degree. So if we get the sum of the angles is 180 degree, then that angles are called supplementary angles. So these angles are supplementary angles. Now let's find these angles are supplementary or not. So what we do, what we have to do to find, is it supplementary angle or not? For that, what we have to do, we have to find the sum of these angles. Okay, so sum of these angles 8 plus 2, 10, 1 is 10, 6 plus 2, 8. So what we got? Sum of these two angles. Sum of these two angles we got 180 degrees. So these angles are called supplementary angles. See, sum of these both the angles we got 180 degrees. So these angles are called supplementary angles. Sum of these both the angles we got 180 degrees. So these angles are also called supplementary angles. Let's see now adjacent angles. Now what do you think by adjacent angles? Adjacent angles have common vertex and common arm. Okay, adjacent angles have a common vertex and a common arm, but no common interior points. That it does not have a common interior points. Okay, adjacent angles have common vertex. Now see these angles. It has common vertex. This is the common vertex. Okay, see, suppose A. This is C. Okay. So now, see these angles. Now it has common vertex O and common arm OC. Common arm OC. So adjacent angles have common vertex. It has common vertex and common arm. Common arm. So which angles are adjacent angles? AOC and COB. These are the two adjacent angles because it has OC is a common arm and O is a common vertex. Why these two angles are adjacent angles? Which two angles are adjacent angles? It has common vertex and common arm. Which is common vertex? O. And which is common arm? OC is the common arm. Angle OAOC and angle COB. These are the adjacent angles, and it has OC is a common arm and O is a common vertex. So these are called the adjacent angles. So adjacent angles have common vertex and common arm. Okay. Let's see now linear pair. What is mean by linear pair? A linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles. Just now we have learned adjacent angles. A linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles whose non-common sides are opposite ray. Non-common sides are opposite ray. So non-common sides, these are non-common sides and these are opposite ray. Okay. The angles in a linear pair are supplementary. So angles in a linear pair are supplementary. Supplementary means what? We form 180 degree angles. So angle 1 and angle 2. These are linear pairs. So angle 1 and 2 are linear pair. Yes. See, a linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles. It has common adjacent angles or not? See, it has common arm. Common arm. This is common arm and common vertex. It has common arm and common vertex. What is adjacent angles? Common. It has in adjacent angles. It has common arm and common vertex. So a linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles. Like this, this is stand, and on that like this, so it has formed a linear pen. What is the major?